Hello and welcome to another video of About Koi. In this video, we will share the breeding process of Nisqigoi at Japanese koi farms. It all starts with the breeding process, the most important activity for a koi farm which determines the future of the farm. It requires knowledge and skill, which in koi breeders' families is passed on generation on generation, whereby most of the breeders make use of a manual spawning process for their best koi varieties in order to maximize the number of offspring. In this video, we will share with you how Japanese koi breeders perform their spawning activities. We take a look at the Maruda koi farm, where we spend time together with the breeders to get a better understanding of the koi breeding process, from preparation until the release to the mud ponds. The breeding process is normally not something that is publicly available. Koi dealers and enthusiasts that travel to Japan normally have no access to participate in these kind of activities together with the breeder. We had a unique opportunity to take a close look at how the process is performed and how manual spawning activities are performed at the Marudo koi farm. The Marudo koi farm is one of the largest koi farms of Japan. The farm has over 100 mud ponds available to grow their koi in. During summertime, it needs over 10 employees on a full-time basis to maintain the farm and perform all activities. The Marudo koi farm, just like many other koi farms in Japan, is making use of concrete ponds as spawning areas. Each of the ponds is provided with a small mesh net and several spawning brushes. Here you can see one of the employees of the Marudo koi farm catch one of the male koi that will be used for breeding. But the first step is to place the female koi in the spawning pond for several hours. Thereafter, usually two, sometimes three male koi are placed in the same pond to get the female ready and in the mood for spawning in the next upcoming night. In Japan, the female and male parent koi are called oyagoi. Oyagoi can be quite old in age. The Kataoka koi farm is for example making use of Sanka oyagoi that are nearly 30 years old. The colors are at that moment not even that sharp any longer, but that doesn't matter for the offspring. It is all about the potential of the parent koi and the power of the bloodline used. Most likely during the night or in the early morning, the oyagoi will start spawning. At Marudo, however, this process is not done on a natural basis. For this reason, the Marudo staff is checking each hour if spawning activity already can be spotted. This means a selected number of staff have to stay awake during nighttime and observe the behavior carefully. And believe me, that these nights can be quite long. The first step is all natural, excluding the few conditions that are created manually in order to speed up and control the process slightly better. This mainly consists of heating up the water temperature. Most Japanese koi breeders choose to manually breed koi to enlarge the number of eggs that will be fertilized. This roughly increases the number of offspring by 3 or 4 times the amount. Especially for varieties like Kohaku, Sanka and Showa, the breeder wants to maximize the number of offspring in order to have a large amount of offspring to select from. Already in the first selection, at an age of 3 to 4 weeks, roughly only 10% of the offspring will be selected for the next round. For one colored koi, like the Chagoi or Karashigoi, the Maruda koi farm applies the natural way of breeding, as for these varieties of Nisqigoi, it is less important to have large numbers to select from. At the moment when the oyagoi start to rush and the male koi more aggressively bumps into the female oyagoi, the Marudo staff will start to prepare the manual process of breeding. The first step is to catch the female koi. A liquid relaxant is added to the water in the bag to calm down the koi and smoothen the process of extracting the eggs. Thereafter the koi is sedated. Everything is very well prepared. All the required materials are placed on a table, ready to use and disinfected. The female koi is threaded with a saline solution to ensure the koi is bacteria free and disinfected. The breeders want to prevent that any water is mixed with the eggs. For this reason, the koi is rolled in towels. As you can see, Keiko is making sure everything is dry. The koi is turned around above the ball and carefully as many eggs as possible are extracted from the female koi. Large female koi produce over 100 thousands of small eggs. The reason why the eggs are so easily extracted and almost fall out by themselves is due to the relaxant that was added to the water before. Toshihiro is making sure that he is extracting as many eggs as possible out of the female koi. This ensures him to have as many offspring as theoretically is possible. In addition, it is also better for the female koi that all eggs are released, as this can result in internal health problems later on. Around 250,000 koi eggs are now in this red bowl. Toshihiro makes sure that also the last eggs are removed. After releasing all the eggs, the koi is placed in the blue container so it can slowly wake up from her sedation. Thereafter it will be released in the same pound as where the spawning activity all started. The male koi are also netted and sedated in a koi bag one by one. A liquid relaxant is added to the koi bag. This will make the process of extracting the sperm easier. The male koi is placed on this foam table. Thereafter the vent is directly cleaned with a saline solution and dried with towels to disinfect and prevent as many bacteria as possible. Before the eggs are mixed with the sperm, Keiko is first taking a sample of this male koi and Toshihiro will perform a check by using the microscope. At the Marudo koi farm, the female eggs are split into two or three batches that will be mixed with sperm of two or three different male koi. Keiko is here preparing the spawning brushes in this blue container. Some koi farms prefer to directly put the spawning brushes in the pond where the eggs will be hatching. At Marudo, this is done in a different way. The eggs are first divided over the spawning brushes, and later on these spawning brushes will be added to the correct ponds to hatch in. Thereafter the sperm can be extracted from the male koi and mixed with the eggs. The eggs and sperm are added into a funnel. This is used in order to equally divide them over the spawning brushes. At Marudo, different spawning brushes are used and uniquely labeled for each female and male combination. This way the breeder can identify and determine for the future which combinations are best, and use this to make his offspring in the future even better. The eggs are carefully dispersed over the spawning brushes, ensuring as many of them stick to the brushes. The breeder wants to prevent that eggs will join on to each other. Too many eggs that stick together or to each other at a single place will decrease the amount of successful hatches. These spawning brushes will be placed in the concrete pounds where the eggs will fully fertilize and hatch. It will take around 4 to 5 days for the eggs to hatch to small koi fish. Toshihiro mentions around 80 to 85% of the eggs will successfully hatch to small koi fry. When the eggs fall down on the spawning brushes, they become sticky and stick to the brushes, as you can see here. The spawning brushes are placed into concrete pounds, where in all rest the eggs have time to hatch. Around 7 days after spawning, the newly hatched koi fry looks like this. It will be counted and prepared to be transferred to the outside growth pounds. Each of these bags consists of around 10 to 25,000 koi fry. These are the so-called mud pounds. From now on, the koi fry are ready to become true nishikigoi. At Marudo, attempts to count the koi fry are performed to ensure each mud pound will only be loaded with a certain number of koi. This is a very important process, as the number of koi fry in a single pound determines the success and growth rate. Having too many koi fry in a single pound will result in depleting the levels of natural available food. Or even worse, resulting in many toby koi in the koi pound. Toby are koi that eat other siblings and for this reason grow even faster. But it costs lives of many other koi fry, and this means less koi to select from. As you can see, Hisashi Hirasawa, the owner of the Marudo Koi farm, is gently mixing the water to ensure the water and temperature differences are as minimal as possible. In these mud ponds, the koi will develop and grow quickly. In about 3 to 4 weeks, it will be small koi of around 2 to 3 cm in size. Whereafter, the small koi will be selected for the first time in their lives, whereby only around 10 to 20% will be selected, and the rest will be discarded. In our next video, I will share the selection process of baby koi with you. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and see you in the next episode.